For this lesson, you need to open the sample file World Sales 5 from your sample files folder. Several elements, such as the chart title, legend, and horizontal vertical axis titles, can be moved by drag and drop. In this lesson, we'll see how you can manually move these elements and how to automatically restore them to their pixel perfect locations if you change your mind. We'll also manually remove and add single chart elements. Once you've got the hang of this, you'll be able to custom design charts for any specific requirement. I'll begin by demonstrating how I can move the chart title element by drag and drop. I'll click on the chart title element to select it, and then hover the mouse cursor over one of the borders of the chart title until I see the four-headed arrow cursor shape. When I see the four-headed arrow, I can click and drag to place the chart title element anywhere within the chart. Now I want to move the chart title element back again so that it's perfectly above the centre of the chart. If you simply dragged with the mouse, you wouldn't be able to position it perfectly at the centre, only approximately. We'll see now how to automatically position the chart title element perfectly in the centre of the chart. To do this, I first click on the element to select it, then it's Chart Tools on the ribbon, and Design. And on the left-hand side of the Design ribbon is the Chart Layouts group. I'm going to click the Add Chart Element button, and you can see the Chart Title element listed. If I place the mouse cursor over Chart Title, you'll see that I have several options to position the chart title, and I'm going to position it above the chart. When I hover over above chart, you can see a preview on the chart of how this will look. And that's exactly what I want, so I click, and the chart title element is now perfectly centered above the chart. Let's now delete a chart element. Perhaps you've decided that you no longer need the legend element, so I'll click just inside the border of the legend element to select it, and press the delete key on the keyboard to delete the legend. Now let's add the legend element back to the chart, but instead of displaying it on the right of the chart, let's display it at the top of the chart. When you activate a chart, you'll notice that three icons appear at the top right-hand side of the chart, and one of those icons is the chart elements icon. I'm going to click the chart elements icon now, and you can see all of the elements that are available within the chart. This is almost the same as the dialog shown when you clicked the Add Chart Element button on the ribbon earlier in this lesson. But you'll usually find this little button to the right of the chart is a more convenient way to add and remove chart elements. Well, if I look down the elements list, I can see there is a legend element available. So I'll hover the mouse cursor over legend, and you can see that it's being visually previewed on the chart. Notice there's a little arrow to the right of legend. If I click on this arrow, you can see that there's several different locations I can add a legend. I'll hover over each in turn. That's on the right, and I can see the preview. At the top, the left, and the bottom. Well, I wanted to add the legend to the top of the chart, so I'll click Top. Now let's add a thin black border to the legend element. You learned how to do this in Lesson 5-7. I'll first click on the legend to select it, then I'll right-click and select Format Legend to bring up the Format Legend task pane. I'll then click on the Fill and Line button and click on the Border Flyout menu. And then I'll select Solid Line. I want this line to be black, so I'll click the Outline Colour button and select a black colour. And I think I'll leave the width at the default, 0.75 points. And now I can close the Format Legend task pane. Now I'm going to resize the legend element so that it spans the entire width of the plot area. If I click on the legend element to select it, you'll notice that sizing handles appear on the corners and sides of the legend. I'm going to hover over the sizing handle on the right-hand edge of the legend, and the cursor shape changes to a two-headed arrow. Now I'll click and drag to size the right-hand side of the legend to the right-hand side of the plot area. And I'll do the same on the left-hand side of the legend. Now let's imagine that this chart is going to be used in a PowerPoint presentation, and you're worried that the font is too small in the legend to be read at the back of the room. We need to increase the font size of the legend element. To do that, I'll first click on the legend element to select it, then Home tab on the ribbon, and in the font group, I'll click on the font size drop-down. As I hover over each font size, you can see the font getting larger in the legend element. I think I'll choose a font size of 14 points, and I click to apply the new font size. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name World Sales 6, and as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 5.9, Move, Resize, Add, Position, and Delete Chart Elements.